Okay, so first thing you have to do is download the Express LRS configurator. I will have a link in the description. So install that. After installed, it will make a shortcut on desktop. This is just a copy and paste of the same shortcut. So open that program. Then you go to official releases and then choose 3.2.0, not 3.2.1, because for some reason the 1 watt module comes from the factory with this software instead of this one, and for some reason if you try to change it to the correct one, this one, but on 4.2.1, it makes keeps failing. So I'll show that later in the video. So instead choose 3.2.0. And then select this. Select the 1 watt or 1000 milliwatt. This one doesn't matter which one you really choose. But yeah, let's make it Wi-Fi. Then select the first one, enter your binding phrase, then enter your home Wi-Fi network name. It's the same one that you'll see here, so exactly like it is, whatever your name is, enter it here, and then your password to log in. And then once this is done, just say build, don't say flash and build. After it was a success, go back and then also download the Lua script without changing any of this. So next thing is plug in your transmitter, choose USB storage, and then in the SD card, go to scripts, tools, and then paste that Lua script there. So under setup, turn your internal off, and your external on to crossfire. So first thing is remember to put the antenna on before powering on to prevent the chip from burning inside. Then secondly, put it on update firmware mode, which is the first two up and all the rest facing down. Either you can give it external power or have it in the transmitter, but if it's in the transmitter, your internal has to be off and your external on in the setup menu, otherwise it won't receive power. And then you'll see it automatically goes to Wi-Fi after a few seconds, and then from here you can do the update on the PC. So here you can see it shows up on Wi-Fi. You connect, password is small letters Express LRS. Then it opens this address on your browser. So here you just choose the file that we already downloaded from the ELRX configurator, the one that was built before.
So if this happens to you, you have to do what I'm going to show next, which is a file you have to upload that fixes this problem in the software, where it thinks that the storage is finished because of the new update being, according to its own calculations, too big. But this error can be fixed. So I'll put a link for a video that you can watch explaining this error, and the guy that made a full video about it, and also the link to where you download this file that you'll need next. Here's the repartitioner.bin file, so you're going to choose that. Let's say update. After that has finished flashing, wait for the Wi-Fi to automatically switch back on and then connect like before. Then it opens this address on your browser. If you paid close attention, you would see that the software I just flashed in the previous example was in fact 3.2.1 and not 3.2.0, as you would have done if you followed the instructions. So what you just saw there was the fail message I was talking about earlier when I said that the 3.2.1 doesn't work. So for some reason, because you try and flash the 3.2.1 1-watt software on the one that came with it, that it's not actually on 1-watt, it gives the fail error. Once you've successfully flashed 3.2.0, then this is the following way you'll have to find Wi-Fi. So you hold in the button, you go down until you see Wi-Fi admin, press it down once, select that one also once, and then again enter, and then it will show this. But the problem with this is this shows the way to connect to it if you haven't flashed it with the home Wi-Fi name and password. And once you put in this and this, the address of your Wi-Fi and the password and the binding phrase, and you flash it, then it won't show up here anymore like it used to in the beginning. The only place now it will show up is in here if you switch on Wi-Fi mode. It won't show here because the funny thing is, in the beginning, out of the box, if you put on Wi-Fi mode and it links through here underneath, then obviously it will disconnect the internet and you can't say build in flash because it doesn't have internet. And you have to build first and go to this, load it there, flash it. So makes sense that basically this enables two networks to connect simultaneously on the same Wi-Fi. So you'll see it will show up here at the bottom. So you say select and then it selects it over here. It will show instead of the COM 1 or COM 7.
So next thing, remember to put it back on operation mode. So it's first two down, middle two up, and then the last three down. Then you can put it back inside the remote. And then the only thing you have to do is to bind.
Welcome to OpenTX.
And then it's a good idea to power it externally, because it takes a lot of power. And the internal power and external power won't clash. You don't have to stress about burning it out or something like that, because as soon as it gets power here, it switches off the power going from here to the back.
Even if you go onto the Lua script on your transmitter and you go to Wi-Fi connectivity, enable Wi-Fi, it still isn't going to show up here. It will only show up inside ELRS configurator, and then you can say select. Same as if you would power the module externally.